Hello, and welcome back to my playthrough of Pokemon Platinum. And in this episode, I'm going to attempt to capture Giratina, and then I'll be going to get the lake legendaries, because I think you can get them as soon as you leave this place. And if you watch my Prince of Persia videos, then you'll know that the recording, the file corrupted in the distortion world, so I had to go from the Verity Lake front back to this part, which is basically 3 hours of recording, because it was three episodes ago. And like an idiot, I forgot to buy more Ultra Balls again, so I'm on 7 Ultra Balls instead of 50, but never mind. But anyway, Giratina's going to show his true form to us. Oh my god, the devil himself. That's what Giratina is. Whereas Arceus is the Pokemon god. So yeah, in one generation, you're introduced to the Pokemon Devil and the Pokemon God. And your Giratina is quite awesome. He's pretty OP as well, because he's a Dragon Ghost. So his defense is very good, and his type weaknesses are completely non-existent. Like, what were Game Freak thinking? It's like they wanted to blimmin' make people rage. So I can tell that two flamethrowers will deal with it, and please don't stat boost it. Oh, thank god. So yeah, two flamethrowers should get it down to maybe red or just before that. Unless it crits, which I'm hoping it doesn't. Anyway, Ancient Power is the weakest move it has, I believe. As long as it doesn't stat boost, I'm fine with it using it. So yeah, I'm just going to go straight to fast forwarding, because I know what's about to happen, so there we go. One tweak, not too bad to start off with, and it's going to use Shadow Force, is it? Well, that's fine, because I can get Happy Barrel, and it's a normal type, so you can't do much against it, sucker! Can you dig it, sucker? Ghost type moves don't affect normal types, bitch. Ha ha ha, up yours, you stupid idiot. No, look, it doesn't mean, because I called you a stupid idiot, you can jump out of your blooming Pokeball, okay? Well, your Ultra Ball, because that was supposed to be your Ultra Ball that you're going to go into, idiot. Never mind. Right, it's being Blaze back out then for now. I will heal Blaze if I have to, but shouldn't have to do it yet, if I have to do it at all. Ah, two tweaks. It's increasing, but I'm hoping it actually means something. Like, keep on gradually increasing every now and then. And why do you have to crit? That is just stupid. Stop it, man. Stop it. Oh, dear. Oh, that's a dodgy move to use. I'm just going to have to heal. I can't take chances hoping it would use a move that won't kill him in that hit. Which is probably just about Ancient Power if it doesn't crit, and Shadow Force, because it takes two moves to do so. But it used Dragon Claw, so I might have actually I'd be on 1 HP. Oh my god. Come on, this is the one. Two tweaks again. You didn't see him because it's fast forward, but all you need to see is the click. Well, see the click and hear the click and the two stars or whatever it is that pops out. No, stop, Giratina. Get in the Ultra Ball. I promise I will treat you nicely. Because I don't have many Pokemon as it is. Are you kidding me? That's the first free tweak we've had. Right, get out Starly, because it's a normal flying. And guess what? Shadow Force doesn't bother Starly. Idiot. See, I could be onto the first reset because I'm not giving up. See if a Dust Ball will do anything. Well, that answers my question. That answers it very nicely. Right, so I don't want to accidentally flee from the battle, because you can do that. And wow, I just noticed he got a stat boost. Well, that's fantastic. Do I chance it? No, I'm not going to chance it. Actually, you know what? No, I might as well keep him out for now. So, what? I've got Luxury Ball, a Heal Ball, a Nest Ball, and a Timer Ball. I'm going to use all the special balls, and I'll use Timer Ball last to give those few extra moves. Oh my god, two tweaks on a luxury ball. Crap. Gonna have to heal more often because of the stat boost. 5 minutes ain't too bad for the first attempt. I know I probably wouldn't do it the first attempt if I'll do it at all. This is ridiculous. Like, I get bad luck when doing it on YouTube. I don't know why, but the curse of YouTube loves to strike. Do you know what, I'm gonna use a nest ball. It might seem stupid, but I saw a YouTuber called Worster do it. What did he do it with? I don't remember now. Or was it some other Pokemon speedrunner. I just watched their video just for a laugh to abide time. Ancient power, if you stat boost again, thank god you didn't. But yeah, I'm running out of balls. That sounds a bit wrong, but well, I'll say I'm running out of Pokeballs, there we go. With all different forms. You're gonna use that again, aren't you? No more actually, now I've got a foodib. That it won't bother. For the first time. Haha, doesn't affect foodib, what you're gonna do, bitch. Probably kill him next turn, but I don't care. Timer ball. Katow. Wow, he didn't even let me make signs of doing it. Haha, another ghost type move that doesn't affect him. Great ball, I doubt that's gonna do jack to it. Yep, thought as much, so now literally I've got to try and use Pokeballs. Are you kidding me? Well, I might as well reset now, but I'm not going to. While I scratch my leg. Alright, come on. Catch it. I refuse to use the Master Ball because I'm using that on Mesprit. If I even get a tweak out of any of these three balls, I'll be surprised. I really will be. And if I catch one, I'll laugh. Well, if I catch it with one. Yep, as a fault. I knew this would happen with the three Pokeballs, but I might as well try for the laugh. Not as much, reset one. Actually, before I do this, I'll pause it and I'll see you in a sec for you. Like an idiot, accidentally ended the video, which is fine, but yes. This is attempt number three, I believe. Is it only two? No, it's only attempt number two. So I could just merge both the videos together, so the 7 minute one and however long this takes. I mean, the full video could be me just trying to catch this stupid idiot. Because it's just stupid, like. Oh, if I did it. Like, without recording it. I'll probably get it. So you know what I'm going to do? If it takes too long, I'm going to pause it until I do it. And I don't care if it isn't, if I don't show me doing it. Because it's just what I'm going to have to do. If you don't like it, I'm sorry. But it's just, I've never known any YouTuber to get as bad luck as this. Well, I mean across like all the games I've done trying to catch legendaries. No, not this unlucky. Well, maybe Worster, but he's a speedrunner, so it affects him more, but I'm not in a rush to do it. Which is a problem, because I'll keep on going until I do it, and that's not a good idea. Oh my god, he survived it. Oh, just get in the Ultra Ball. Yes! Oh my god. Oh my god, I nearly dropped my phone. Ah, oh, thank god. Do you know what? No, I'm not having anything happen. Oh my god. Oh my god, yeah, as you can see, I've been using a lot of save slots because of what happened. Thank god for that. Wow, it took what? 9 minutes in total? Wow, oh. That was quicker than I expected. Thank you, RNG gods, for being nice to me. I'm not nicknaming a legendary. That's, like, bad. I think I accidentally did it. Anyway, yes. I'll take it off a fast-forward now. Giratina seems to have understood us. That Pokemon. That shadowy Pokemon was captured. Your doing so means it's a rational world remain in existence. Does that make it impossible for me to create a new world? Even if I made new red chains, the new world can't be made. Why? What compels you to protect the two worlds? Is spirit a vague and incomplete thing so important to you? The places we are born, the time we spend living, the languages we speak. We are all different, but the presence of Pokemon unites us. We share our lives with our Pokemon, and our happiness grows as we all become greater than we are alone. That is why we can battle and trade with anyone we choose. Silence! Enough of your blathering. That's how you justify spirit as something worthwhile? That is merely humans hooping, deluding themselves that they are happy and safe. The emotions roiling inside me. Rage, hatred, frustration. These ugly emotions arise because of my own incomplete spirit. Enough. We will never see eye to eye. This I promise you, I will break the secrets of the world. With that knowledge, I will create my complete and perfect world. One day, you will awaken to a world of my creation. A world without spirit. Siri's just gonna F off. Anyway. Since there is sadness, we can feel joy. When there is anger, compassion is born. Let's go back home. Oh god, that was bad. The portal where Giratina should lead back to our world. Giratina was written in legend as being on the other side of our world. It stands to reason that it has a link to the other side. And yes, like an idiot, I forgot to get the Pokétech up again, but it's fine. This place. It's the send-off spring. It's said to somehow lead to the great beyond. And Giratina was said to live in a world on the opposite side of ours. Yeah, where she's blocking now, that's where you can get the second chance to catch Giratina. Oh, I'm sincerely sorry. It's very rude of me. Phantom, you're incredible. You really are a fantastic trainer. Let me say this on behalf of all Sinnoh. Phantom, thank you. Oh, that's right. You have to go tell Prof. Rowan. He was very worried about you. You should visit him at his lab. That's what I'll go do now. Oh god, I'm glad I got it done quite quickly. Nearly dropped my phone in the process, but never mind. So yeah, I'll go heal up my Pokemon first. Go get loads of Pokeballs and stuff like that. Well, Ultra Balls. I'm going to get 75 in total. Well, up to 75. That means I won't have to buy 75, because I think I had 3 left after the one that I used, and it actually worked. But wow, I'm so glad that I did it. I know it might not seem like a big deal, and it might seem as though I was lucky for doing it in 10 minutes. Yes, I am lucky. But that's good for even off-air standards when I do it normally. Wow. That has surprised me, I will say. Oh, so I had 2 left, so 73 then. You might be thinking, Adam, what the hell are you doing? This is too many, but... It's not when you're trying to catch 3, well, 2 legendaries because Mesprit is getting masterballed. There we go. Max potion, how many of these bad boys have we got? Oh. We get 28 of them. Might as well do this big shopping now. Max repels. I ended up using 11. I don't remember how many I used beforehand, but obviously I didn't quite get it the same way. I mean, I forgot to say Blaze was on level 74 instead. Anyway, how much like experience has he gained through that level? Let's have a look. Not a lot, but I won't use the rare candies yet. Anyway, yes, time to go. Phantom, you've come back. You leave me speechless. You've done it. You really have done it. Never has my heart pounded this hard for so long in my 60 years of living. The professor did a lot of checking up after you left. He was really worried about you, Phantom. He contracted acquaintances looking for help, and... Phantom, I'm glad to see you safe. Welcome back. Yay, she just wants his pants down, let's face it. Oh, yes, there was something I had to tell you. The 3 Pokemon of the Lakes appear to have returned to their homes. So tell me, how are things going for you? The the Pokédex? A total of 160. And the number of badges? Well, you've got 7 already. That only leaves Sunny Shore's gym. You've come this far. Why not obtain Sunny Shore's badge? And why not challenge the Pokémon League? Oh, I'm going to be doing that, but after I've got the Lake Spirit Pokémon. That will broaden your horizons further than ever before. Not to mention the opportunities to meet even more Pokémon. Do you know what? Stop. Because I know what the route is next. Hang on, I'm going to pause it a sec. Nothing important, only a game thing. Wait, I got 77, did I accidentally buy 70? Oh, idiot, never mind. Anyway, what was I looking for? Crap, don't remember what I was looking for now. No, oh, right, yes, that's what I was going to do, innit? 75. Oh, that level up there, that's actually pretty good. And again, Katow. Might as well use it now. Rare candy, Katow. That was an alright level up. Weren't as good as last time, I don't think, but never mind. Right, so yes, I'm gonna go get that Pokétech up again. You already see me get it, so I'll leave it. Off we go into Verity Lakefront. Or Lake Verity now. Oh, bit of a lag spike. Right, before I actually go into the cave, I am going to spray a repel because there are like areas that you can go to get some items that are scattered across the three lakes. I think this one's the top left, one of them's the bottom right, and one of them's the bottom left. This is the bottom left. Feels weird to go so slow because I blooming went off 400 times speed to catch up because I didn't really want to leave the playthrough in the dust for too long because of what happened. Never mind. I'm back here now, and I think this is the thing that shows the Pokemon heads, unless you have to get the 8th gym badge first. I don't know. Anyway, here's Mesprit. If you do, I'll get Mesprit afterwards. Phantom, that was Mesprit, wasn't it? You've accomplished what I'd asked you to do at Kanalav Library. I asked you to get data on the Pokemon of the lake, and you did. But it didn't provide any answers about the mysteries of evolution. I still don't know why some Pokemon evolve and others don't. Ultimately, it only deepened the mystery. But having mysteries to solve, that adds to my enjoyment. Phantom, why don't you chase after Mesprit? To me, it seems as if it wanted to play with you. If you were able to use the Pokétech app marking map, you'd be able to track the movements of Pokémon. Go on, Phantom. I'm sure that you will keep meeting countless Pokémon and people. Those encounters will keep thrilling you in their own special ways. I hope you enjoy that experience. Take care, Phantom. So I think this is the app. Yes, it is. Good. So now I'm going to wait for it to go to the route to the right of Jubilife, because that's the one I like it to go to. So every time I use Fly, it goes to a completely random different area. And every time I go to a different route or town, it moves one route. It doesn't really have a set pattern, which can be annoying. So what I'm hoping is that it goes over to the route on the left. And as soon as it does, it's getting saved. Right, so not there. Right, so just keep on doing this until it comes over. By the way, this could take a long time. And I mean a long time and all. Oh, don't do this. You're going the wrong way now, Mesprit. Come on. See, so it can be annoying to find the roamers. I mean, it can be hard to catch the roamers as well. No, wrong way. Come on, down. Here, no. What are you doing? Mesprit, come on. Right, I'm going to pause it until it comes to this route. It could be 10 minutes from when I pause it, but see you in a sec. A Mesprit just landed in this route. Yes, it did. Yes, it did. Oh, yes, it did. If you're wondering why I'm doing this, because of what happened, I'm just changing the slot every time I save until I have to go back to 1. Oh, found it. And yeah, because it's a roamer, it flees every time you blooming get near it. Anyway, yeah, I'll just fast forward it just to make it easier. So yeah, very hard Pokemon to catch. So I'm going to enjoy this. Let's count it down, shall we? One tweak, two tweak, three tweak, pow. I was so hoping it wouldn't fail, because apparently it has a very, very small chance of failing, even though it's not supposed to, and I was hoping that wouldn't happen. But yes, that's the most annoying one of the three to get. But I'm going to have a pit stop on the lake Pokemon, because there's something else I need to get yet. And I forgot to get it. I said I was going to get it after Eterna City, and I never did. Like an idiot. See, I don't know why the thing's still showing that it's there, because it isn't there. Anyway, yeah, it took me so long to get it, because I used the Master Ball on thingy. Giratina, and I actually got it properly. Well, in a way, without using the Master Ball. Which ain't too bad, considering the YouTube curse seemed to be imminent. What am I doing? Yes, it is up here. Alright, so that's two legendaries in 20 minutes. That's not too bad. Alright, yeah, you get this bit. Blah, blah, blah. I could have done this ages ago. Never mind, I'm not going to talk about it. So you can get old, is it called Old Gatto or something? I don't know. Or it's just Old Chatter, I don't know. It's like this, healing item, I believe. I think it's only like 30 HP, it's near the beginning of the game anyway. Hang on, I don't know what the time is on here, let's have a look. This is why I left it, wouldn't it? So it's 2:17, crap, I think that might be too late. No, please don't tell me it is too late. Get back. If I have to, I'll change the time settings. Oh, there's an item there I can go get quickly. It better not be too late. I think it might be 2:30 actually, so I might be able to get it. But I'll change the time settings if I have to. That's fine. But I don't know if changing the time settings will change it on here or not. Hopefully I can get Rotom, which is basically motor backwards. It's this electric ghost type, and you have to go to a certain thing. I'll just mention it now in case I can't really show getting it because it's too late to. Alright, so this is the TV. Right, so it is this time. Good, I can do it still. I think it's between 10 to 2 o'clock or 1:30, something like that. So here goes Rotom. This is the reason why I put thingy at the front. Barrel, because it's level 20, so yeah. I want to try and catch it at least. Might as well. I didn't actually catch it last time because I kind of screwed myself over. Anyway, Surf. This won't do much because it's electric ghost, but it's a start. Wow, that did a bit too much to what I wanted. Oh wow. Everything happened to be barrel then. Right, I need to see the moveset of matchup. Is it literally just fighting type moves here? Wow, it is. I'm gonna have to just try and catch it from here then. Let's ultra ball it. We're balling. Right, I'm gonna fast forward again. Let's see how long this bitch takes. You can do that if you want, mate. I don't care, Rotom. Yeah, as I said, it is motor backwards, and you can look to see. Ooh, nearly did it on the second one. You can use double team. It's not like it changes the catch rate. It just makes your moves harder to hit you, even though I won't be hitting you anymore, I don't think. Come on. Oh, come on, no. Oh, I knew it'd probably be a bit of a trouble, but I was hoping it wouldn't be this much of trouble. Come on. Oh, you son of a bitch. I knew that was going to happen. Time to try again. I'm surprised it hasn't killed Bibarel yet, to be fair. Yay, there we go. That's Rotom down. Two more. Yeah, as I said, electric ghost. I won't nickname a legendary. Don't see the point in doing that. So yeah, I'm literally gonna just explore this area to get items. They might be crap this time, but Dreadplate is for Arceus. I believe that they were all for that. I don't know. Anyway, yes, I might as well just finish exploring this place. That was just for the bed. What's in here? Nothing. What's in here? Ace, well, the move substitute. I don't really like substitute. I find it kind of pointless, but never mind. That's my opinion. Really, I can't, well, of course, can't blooming bike indoors. I mean, look what happened to Gary in the Pokemon anime. He went and got himself in the hospital for using his bike. After the echoed words of the professor saying that there's a time and place for everything. There's old Gatto. I knew it was old Gatto. Don't know why I question myself. I'm an idiot. Like, I know it what it is, but I still question if it is or not anyway. Oh, well, yeah, I'm not exploring that. It's probably nothing there anyway. So I'm guessing I'll have to leave the forest completely before I can fly. So I'll go to Snow Point and do Azelf now. So off I go. So how many legendaries is that so far? Three? Oh, beautiful. Right, so I'll switch over these two again now. Fly away to Snow Point City, where the snow is white and the girls are pretty. Not really, but because they're like just animations, but yeah. Anyway. Oh yes, I know what I might as well do as well. The roots underneath Sandgem Town. Might as well do that them in this episode. So I won't really be making any real progress properly. Well, it depends how long the legendary hunt takes. I mean, it's been 27 minutes so far. Counting the 7-minute video that I did that I accidentally got rid of like an idiot. Well, I didn't get rid of it, but I just accidentally stopped the recording. So, off I go. Spray another repel, because I might as well. Spray, 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 spray. Spray, spray, spray. So yeah, as you probably gathered, Uxie and Azelf are not roamers. You can just get them in the cave. I mean, Uxie and Azelf didn't find too bad to catch before, but you never know. They could be bad now, thanks to the YouTube curse. Dun dun dun. Oh no, not the YouTube curse. Well, nothing there. Should have thought as much. You're a blizzard, Harry. Haha, you get it? Yeah, anyway. Time to use Surf yet again. And it's time to save it again. Yeah, I forgot to say, Uxie is the defensive one, eyes closed. Azelf is the offensive one, eyes open. And Mesprit is balanced, eyes half open. Forgot to mention that. So yeah, here is Azelf with the eyes closed because it's the defensive one. Just thought that would be some trivial fact for you. I found that out. But anyway, Blaze shouldn't one-shot Uxie. with a flamethrower. If he does, he's a twerp. Oh god, that's amazing. That's actually the best. Do you know what? You can put him to sleep. Do you know why? Because I'm going to try and catch you, you blooming idiot. So this is why it's defensive. It doesn't really use really that big attacks. It just tries to weaken in a different way. It's more defensive. So I think it does use like defensive wall or block type moves, because Mesprit has two defensive moves and two offensive moves because it's balanced. I believe, anyway. I'm not going to check. They all have future sight as well, and they're psychic types. I believe they're all psychic types. I don't know if they have a second type or not, I don't remember now. Yeah, the Lake Trio. Oh, alright, they're not the best legendary trio, but they're alright. I prefer the Dragon Trio. Well, I guess Arceus kind of counts as well. I don't think he's a dragon, he's just normal type, but he can become any type eventually. But yeah, I knew Uxie would be a bitch to catch, but that's fine, because I've got 66 more. Pow, 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 pow. Less than 10, oh my god. Luck is finally coming to me. Right, so it's just psychic type, fair enough. Right, so I'll fly to the next city. No, not England. And then heal up Pokemon because Blaze is asleep. And then go to the... Not Verity, not Aquity, what's the other one? Valor Lakefront, there we go. What we're doing. Anyway. Time to rest my Pokemon again. Oh yes, God, I need to stop these voice cracks, it's so annoying. But yes, now I'm looking for legendary Pokemon number 5. Yeah, as I said, if you want to see me catch Arceus, Darkrai, and I don't remember the leaf legendary Pokemon. I don't know what it's called. It's grass type, it's like a leaf type thing. There's Demfra, I don't know if there's any more event ones. But if you want to see me at least catch them three, leave a comment down below. Unless you want to leave me all alone, forever alone, and not say, then that's still fine. I guess. No, I'm not going in there. When I can go round. You spin me right round, baby, right round. Like a record, baby, right round, right round. Time to go down, baby, go right down. I'm gonna spray a repel cause I need to, cause I don't wanna have too many random battle encounters, cause I just wanna cut to the point and cut to the chase, shall we say. So you haven't done bad, to be fair, considering the amount of time I've managed to catch 4 legendaries. I mean, it's treating me nicely for a change. I mean, Giratina was, was the hardest one to catch, as I thought it would be. So I'm guessing this bottom corner is where it is. No, it's in the middle. Oh no, it isn't, that's a troll. How dare you troll, nasty troll. Boo, boo, boo. See, I wonder if Uxie is going to be the worst of the three. Well, I don't know, I guess we'll see. Yeah, I could have got these before, but I thought I'll get them when I get the legendaries. And yeah, I would do the Battle Frontier as well, but that might take too long. Anyway, what am I doing now? Uxie was the other one. This is Azelf. What am I on about? Ignore me, I got them completely wrong. Idiots. Idiot, idiot, idiot. So Uxie is the defensive one. Azelf is the offensive one with his eyes open, and Mesprit, as I said, half open, half closed. God, I'm an idiot. Got mixed up. Why? I noticed it was yellow, and all I didn't pay attention. Like an idiot. But because Azelf is more offensive, a flamethrower might one-shot it, because it might have lower defense. I don't know. I'll still try a flamethrower, though, of course. Come on, please don't one-shot a legendary. That'll be quite bad on the legendary's behalf. Wow, it is an all. Right, okay then, fair enough. Right, I'll pause it while I load state. Right, let's resume where we left off. Let's blast off to oblivion! God, I shouldn't do that. God, I'm an idiot. Anyway, time to defeat Azelf. Well, not defeat it, but use a flame wheel on it. And hopefully cut to the chase. It's better not crit and blimmin' defeat it. Oh wow, that was a flame wheel, by the way. That swift never misses, fair enough. I'll Mach Punch, because this shouldn't do much, because it's psychic type. Oh god, that's a beautiful man. Oh. But yeah, Azelf is probably going to be hard to catch in terms of when you eventually run out of time. You just eventually get weak and could possibly die. Or faint. Because it's more offensive. But let's see if it wants to be a bitch. Don't use Swift on me ever again, you bitch. To be honest, I haven't seen a Swift since Gen 2, and I gave it to Quilava. I was going to say Quilava then. Quilava, I should say. Wheel. Oh, great, I took the Future Sight attack. Never mind. If fast-forwarding really helps here, it just, like, cuts to the chase. Kind of. You're causing an uproar, are you? Luckily, it isn't that much of a big threat in terms of move. And it just keeps on using uproar until it stops making the uproar. And it still damages you, but never mind. What's the time? 36 minutes, because I'm adding on the 7. That's not too bad. So this is Ultra Ball number 6. I know it'd probably be harder. Not just because it's a more offensive one. It's got nothing to do with that. I just, for some reason, Azelf wants to be a bitch, and like an idiot, I thought Uxie was here and Azelf was there, but this is where Azelf is. So this was the place that gave me trouble. There will be trouble ahead. Ultra Balls are not catching the stupid Pokemon. So you're gonna uproar again. You an idiot. I'm gonna use a Hyper Potion for now. Well, I managed to get 4. Well, not easily, but pretty good from standards of how I usually do it. And how much luck I have. And then Blooming Azelf, as per usual, has to be the one. It just doesn't want to get in the Ultra Ball. Like, how dare it? Oh my god. It's like, got hardly any health left and all. But I will say, one good thing is that the legendaries didn't get burnt at all. Well, I mean, other than Giratina. Did it get burnt? I'm sure it did. Unless that's before. I'm sure it did get burnt. I don't remember that. Well, I've got brain like a blimmin' goldfish. And a memory like one and all. You use uproar, I don't care. Just get in the ball. Not get in the bowl, get in the ball. Oh, son of a bitch. You want to get 3 tweaks, dear, and you want to manage to get out then? Screw you. You're no Giratina, you shouldn't take multiple blooming Ultra Balls to get blooming captured. It's a good thing I have over 50 left, isn't it? It's a good thing Uxie was captured quick. And Rotom. I nearly did forget about Rotom, to be fair. Oh, come on. Don't be an idiot. Do I have my Dusk Ball left? I think I do. Oh, I won't use it yet, but I guess I could do if I wanted to, but I won't. I'll stick to the Ultra Balls. Now get in the ball! Oh my god, one tweak, really? I don't get why it has appeared to be caught on one tweak. Just because it's struggling. Wow, whoa. Fantastic. Right, this is Ultra Ball number 16. Holy crap. I had a feeling it was going to be a pain, but wow. This is munching up the rest of the video time. But it's fine, it's fine. It's getting in whether he likes it or not. I don't care. It's gonna be like, get in my belly type thing. I weren't trying to do it, so don't worry, it wasn't like a crap impersonation. So yeah. 50 Ultra Balls left, fantastic. And I have still got Dialga, Palkia, maybe Cresselia, maybe Heatran, maybe Darkrai, and maybe Arceus, and maybe that Leaf one left to get. Wow. And the Legendary Bird Trio, but the Legendary Bird Trio and Cresselia, I might not get because they're roamers, and I am not wasting time like that. No way. So I'll leave them. I'll at least trigger the event for Cresselia and Darkrai, though. Well, maybe Darkrai, if you want me to do it, as I said. Cresselia isn't an event one. Thank you, Azelf. Thank you. God, I'm starting to get bored. Oh. No, I wasn't really starting to get bored. I'm just not making that up. There we go. See, I'm going to use every save slot other than zero, because that seemed to be the one it failed on. God, the emulator doesn't like Chris Brown. Ba-dum-tsh. I'm going to see if I can trigger the event to get the two orbs as well by going to speak with Cynthia's Nan. So let's go to Celestic Town. And yeah, there's still a lot I'm going to be doing. Well, not a lot, but still a few bits before I actually go to Sunny Shore. Like I said, the three routes connecting to whatever the battle place is. Wow, man. I can't believe I managed to get all five this episode. Whew. Legendary hunt was pretty good. But at least they allow you to get a few legendaries before you, what's the word I'm thinking of? Finish the main game. I mean, that's five. You can get maybe seven if you can get Dialga and Palkia, but they're both level 70. So, yeah. And why the hell did I forget to pick up this item? That's a dragon fang. I'm not really using dragon types. Not yet, anyway. Anyway, where does the elder live? Is it this one? No. No, definitely not. Don't look like no elder. Oh, idiot. She lives here. Why is my brain gone dead? Let's see if the event triggers yet. Oh, so not yet. So maybe you can't do it until afterwards. Maybe because they're level 70, you can't do it till end. Right, that's fair enough, fair enough. But that's something to note down. But yeah, as you now know, that is Dialga. And that's Palkia. But anyway, enough of this jibber-jabber. Enough of this jibby jabbery woo. Woo woo way. Time to go to sandgem. And go down, 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 down. Down, 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 down. Give me that. Right, I'll stop. See, I think there's 210 Pokemon altogether you have to get. And then when you get, when you find all 210, that's when you can do the post game stuff properly. Dialga and Palkia count, all the legendaries count, so yeah, you have to basically find all the legendaries at least once, so you can do it. Anyway, yes, I don't know how hard these battles are going to be. So let's go, Jellyfish. Oh my god, is it going to start? Is it going to start? Come on, no, no, I want a Tentacruel. And you know why, viewers, don't you? Oh yes, you do. Oh, yes, you do. Wow, they're level 31. I'm going to breeze through all this. I can just tell. But it's fine. Hopefully. Hopefully you don't mind. Wow. It's actually taken quite a while. I've like all the well, not really, because I paused it for a little while, but never mind. And what's that percentage? Ooh, it's going to have to be on charge in a sec. Really, you let me down, Tuber. I was expecting a Tentacruel. I know you can get very tough Tentacruels in the water, like in the actual water itself, but I'm not gonna blimmin' not spray a max repel and waste time just to find one, and I can just wait into the trainer battle, because you have to find one, because it's a part of the Pokédex. and you've got to find all the ones in the Pokédex of Sinnoh before you can continue. Here's where the path splits, well, in a second. You can go one way, go the other. I like to go the way where there's just one battle first. Well, I believe there's only one battle. I don't think you get anything else going down either, but I'll still go check. Anyway, yeah, this is going to be easy. I could have came here before, but never mind. I could go for about another 15 minutes, but I don't know. Depends how long this takes. It might take longer than 15 minutes, and I'll just have to finish this off another time. But I'm just coming here with something to do. So here's a Mach Punch. How powerful. So level 77 is a beautiful level to be on. At this point, I mean, Sunny Sword Gym is sure, ba-dum-tsh, even though that weren't meant to be a pun, to be a breeze, hopefully. Might even be able to be on level 80 by the time that gym ends. But, I mean, I do like Faulkner as a gym leader. He is my favourite one. You don't really see him much. Well, you don't really see many of the gym leaders much. But he just gets bored of the fact that he doesn't get much competition, as soon as he's like the best gym leader. But oh, I'm gonna give him a good challenge, all right. I'm gonna make him the challenger and me the gym leader. Oh yes, that's how confident I am. And he uses electric types as well, so I find the route to Sunnyshore harder than the gym because of one thing, and I bet you viewers can guess if you think about it. Oh yes, you guessed right. Gyarados, yay! And I'm still disappointed because I haven't seen a tentacle. Caitlin better have one. After this, better do. After this Sea King, it better be a tentacle. Well, there we go, that comes that alert. But it's fine. It should last 15%. I don't need battery saver because it dims the lighting. And it might make it too dark. What? Oh no, not a Medicham, no! See, like, I'm so disappointed for seeing a tentacle, even though, like, they're not the best. They're, like, so annoying sometimes. And I actually want to see it. I know it makes no sense. But I just want to see one so I can sing the song. You treat me like a fool. No, I'll save it. I'll save it a moment, you see. I'll save it a moment. So let's await. Yeah, as I said, I don't think there's any more battles along this bit. Oh, well, no, there's not. I was going to say, oh, yes, there is, but then that you can get there through the other thing as well. Alright, so now I'll go the other way. So that way is an easier way because there's less battles to do. Do 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 bum 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 do 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 do. So I've got four chances to see a tentacle here, and I bet none of them are gonna be a tentacle. Bet one of them is gonna be a tentacle though, which was just rub it in my face on purpose. Never mind. Yeah, I should probably stop banging on about it. I should stop now. I just can't help myself. It's just like, it's just so amazing. Mach Punch, where are you? Here I am, how do you do? I don't know why I'm doing that, just ignore me. Oh dear. Yep, just looks like they're all going to be Goldeens, or the next one's going to be a Sea King or something, I don't know. Sea King or something. Come on. I wanna see one, but I bet I ain't gonna see one. Of course not, but it was a Sea King, I called it. La la la. La 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 la. I don't even think I'm gonna be able to get through these routes by the end of this, but never mind. But if I do get through all these routes, I will fly to Pastoria. And just end the episode there, and then I can go do the rock climbing bits where that villa is, and yeah, carry on from there. Because I mean, it has been 50 minutes now, counting the 7, because I think it was like 7:50, it could have been, I don't know. I could be completely wrong, or completely right. Probably completely wrong. Really, a Finneon? This is pathetic. Also, because it would be one, it would just be a tentacle, because, like, it's actually hard enough to only be a Pokemon on its own, but... Oh, you let the team down, Swimmer. It's just a shame. It's just a shame. It's just all a big, massive, juicy shame. Yeah, I'm just so happy because, like, the legendaries weren't too much of a bitch to catch. I just got to hope Diagra and Palkia won't be too bad, but I have a tendency to try and remember how many Ultra Balls it takes to get a Pokemon. It took 8 for Palkia and 3 for Dialga. I actually prefer Dialga, just because of Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, where you get Primal Dialga. Oh my god, what a Pokemon that is. What a game. I know I keep on banging on about that, but do you know what? I don't care. It's just such a great game. And it actually gives you the feels as well. Not exactly crying, but... I mean... Some people might find some parts of it emotional. I mean, it's not like I'd cry at it, but... Some people would do. Because some people are really sensitive. And I mean really sensitive. I don't mean my level of sensitive, because I can be a soppy git sometimes. I'll say that much. But anyway, back to Pokemon itself, or Pokemon Platinum. I have nearly done this area, I think, because I don't think there's many in the next area. And here I do not get this. I'm guessing it turns into Noctillery, because Remoraid's like a bullet, and Noctillery is an artillery. And so it's called Octillery. It just doesn't make sense. I mean, it just makes it weird. It just makes it have no sense whatsoever. But, never mind. Oh, Sword Tenta. Oh my god, that is the biggest tease ever. How dare you? Oh, you son of a bitch. Oh, that's cruel. Nah, I guess you have to see a tentacle at least, because I don't think I've actually seen one yet. You do have to get everyone on the Pokédex to be able to unlock the full post-game experience. Actually, I'll go for about another 5 minutes. I'll go till it's 50, actually. And then that'll be a 57-minute video. So yeah, I doubt I'll get through all these routes yet, but never mind. Right, now, why is it on here? Idiots. Oh wow, yes, two little bits I can go to. Crap, that's not good. Oh great, I don't like it when the path splits like this. This might just be a trolley bit anyway. Wow, it is an all. Oh no, it ain't. No, it ain't. Ignore me. Oh, it is. Never mind. But I'll go up to the top bit next. I'll go for about another 4 minutes, and then I'll just say in the beginning of the next episode, in this episode, I'm going to finish exploring these optional routes, then I'll go to the village, do all the rock climb bits, go to the route of Sunny Shore Gym, and then get to Sunny Shore Gym, and do the gym itself. Let's see if I remember to actually say that. Let's see if I remember saying what I just said, because, as I said, sometimes I have a memory of a goldfish. But at least I remember the more important things and actually get me through life. I mean, not remembering something in Pokemon isn't really going to affect something in my life now, is it? Let's face it. But I mean, they are a good franchise. I mean, people say they're a kid's game, but... God, the amount of adults that played Pokemon Go, I mean, like, come on. And their excuse is that they played it for the nostalgia. No, they just wanted to play a Pokemon game again. I don't blame them. For playing Pokemon Go, I mean, I never played it, because I just didn't really think much of it. And I mean, look what happened with it. I mean, it died out so quickly. And no, I don't want to see a Pelipper, I want to see a Tentacruel. Come on, this would be so great to, like, end the episode with a Tentacruel. Oh my god. And then this episode will be complete, catching 5 legendaries in, what, 40 minutes? And then just seeing a Tentacruel to end it. Come on, please. on the inside. No, I'm not. I'm just going to get on with it. Anyway, Mac Punch. Screw you, bitch. Ah, you're feeling. You're feeling lucky, punk? Oh, wow, 7%. Ah, it's not going to last much longer, anyway. It was on 90%, and then it's just... This video's just taken the battery out of this blooming... Oh, it's going to have to be a double battle. Never mind. Never mind. I'll just have to end it with a double battle. I mean, I've got about 5 minutes before it goes to the hour anyway, and I doubt this is going to take 5 minutes. Can I have 2 Pokemon each? Oh, no. It's going to be rubbish. Come on, please. Have one. Yes! Oh, thank God. I called it. I knew it was going to happen. I knew it was going to happen. So, are you ready? You treat me like a fool. Because you're a tentacruel. And I'm going to kill the Floatzel first so I get it. Keep it alive. You treat me like a fool. Cause you're a tentacruel. Tentacruel. Bubble beam. Tenter used. Bubble beam. This video is now completely amazing. Yes, I'm sorry if that was like a cringe comp, but I just like, what has my brother done? He's like cursed me so that I have to sing this song that he created. Oh my God, he's created a masterpiece. You need to go watch his videos. I've mentioned his name before. I'm gonna mention it again because everyone, you need to go to him. And you need to get him to make an EP. He needs to sell records because he is a great songwriter. I mean, look at this amazing song that he made. Because all I mentioned when I was playing through Pokemon White for the first time was I saw a tentacle, by the way. And he just sang this song and then, wow. Like, it's just made this complete. And I hope this past 2 minutes have not ruined the video. Anyway, yes, this might be the final bit, I don't know. So, no, I'll do this battle first, and then I'll go on to land, and then end it there. I mean, it won't hurt. But yes, wow, this is complete. 5 legendaries in a 40-minute space, and seeing a tentacruel, oh my God. This is going to make me cry with happiness, I'll tell you now. Oh my God. Yeah, I'm just keeping an eye on the battery, but it should be fine. I'm keeping an eye on the time. But yeah, I nearly got to level 78 during all this. But I'm guessing I'm going to see an artillery after this Remoraid. So you go from a bullet to an artillery. I'm guessing it's supposed to be a bullet. I don't know. Oh no, a Floatzel, that is random. Thought it was going to be the Remoraid evolution line then, but never mind. Bye bye, Floatzel. At least I saw you next to a tentacle. Oh, I'm just like, I'm never going to forget that. Now, every time I see a tentacle, I'm just going to remember that. Like, even if I see it on the glazed, I'm going to do it. If I see it on a ROM hack, I don't care. But anyway, yes, now I will end the video. I will save state, wherever. I mean, look at that. This is the bit, slot one. That's where I had to go back to. But anyway, yes, I'll save over this now. And it's time to call it a good day's work. And I'm going to save it on slot 1, 2, and 3. Because I'm going to be weird now because of what happens. But anyway, yes. I hope you have enjoyed this episode. This has been one of the better episodes because I've been on a legendary hunt. And who doesn't like hunting legendaries? But anyway, yes. Enough of me blabbing on. As I said, I hope you have enjoyed this episode. And in the next episode, I'm going to finish off doing these few routes. Going to do the villa, like all the rock climb bits so you can get to like different items, all that stuff. And go to the route to get to Sunny Shore City. Then do the gym. And then I'll probably end it just outside Victory Road. Unless I still have time to continue after that. But until then, as I said, thank you for watching. It's been me, Adam P. Plays, with a massive thumbs up. Even though you can't see it. I wish you a very good goodbye. And a very nice good night. See you next time. The Prince of Persia, Two Thrones.